in a case that's raising hopes and fears about the future of Roe versus Wade, Alabama's governor faces a major decision, whether to sign a bill that bans nearly all abortions in the state. Lawmakers passed the bill last night. It would make performing an abortion a felony at any stage of pregnancy. It grants exemptions to save the life of the mother, or if the unborn child has a serious medical problem, but not for rape or incest. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi has been following this story. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. Planned Parenthood threatens to sue. They call this bill dangerous, but supporters of it hope for that legal fight. They want it to go all the way to the Supreme Court. They hope with a majority of conservative justices, they'll overturn precedent, the 1973 ruling legalizing abortion.
25 ayes, 6 nays, 1 abstention. House Bill 314 passes.
Alabama passes the country's most sweeping ban on abortion.
A life is a life, and even if it is, its origins are in very difficult situations, that life is still precious.
It's meant as a challenge to the Supreme Court's Roe v. Wade. This bill does allow abortion to save the life of the mother or if there's a deadly problem with the unborn baby. Otherwise, all abortions are felonies.
It's the doctor that's going to go to jail for life. So we're there one time in it. So all we tell her now, go back to the back alleys. Go back to where it was before it was legal.
I would hope that that no female would do that in the future. I would hope that.
I like the way you said it, but the realities are, if they raped or incest or whatever like that, that may be the only option that they have.
And in my opinion, and the crux of the bill, that life is worth preserving. Even at that point.
As the nation debates the future of abortion, we question the state's U.S. senators. One Democrat.
I thought it was shameful.
One Republican.
I have no idea, you know. All I do is read about it. I'm busy here.
Senate Democrats pounce.
It should never have passed. The governor should not sign it. And if she does, it ought to be swiftly struck down by the courts.
Pro-life groups like Priests for Life are urging Governor Kay Ivey to sign the bill. Sponsors of it expect that she will. Now, a Knights of Columbus Marist poll back in February found 29% of Americans either want abortion banned or only allowed to save the life of the mother. That number grows to 58% if you add the exemptions for rape and incest. Lauren?
Well, it seems Congressman Shelby of Alabama hasn't made up his mind yet. We'll have to see what he has to say. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi, thank you.